Here I am, folks, again in Central Park. It's July 5th. I'm in Central Park South on one of the carriage roads, whatever you want to call these things. Looking at this, the GM building on 59th. All the Central Park South. Filled to capacity residences and hotels. And somebody so rudely cut me off. It distracted me. I've learned over the years to look away from distractions. Look what I found. The Helmsleys gave some to New York. This is probably from the Queen of Mean. When I first got to New York in 1982, I think it was 82, there was a New York Times Magazine interview of Harry Helms. Harry was kind of the old man developer. Very successful, and in his interview they said, how do you define success? And Harry replied, at the end of the day, he who dies with the most money wins. I still laugh. I'm gonna go sit in this bench. Hang on a minute. God bless you, Harry. You made my day today. I suppose I should add, as I sit on this bench, that in 2000, I came to the conclusion, you know, how much funny money was out there, beginning with petrodollars and all kinds of other worthless stuff. That money really wasn't the currency anymore. The currency was accurate information. So my addendum to what Harry said is, he who dies with the most accurate information wins. Turned out to be quite true. Except I'm not dead yet. And I'm handing a whole lot of it to other people. They have some of their own to add to. It'll be the collective that wins, actually. Information belongs to the collective.